gifts of beauty rich and rare. In history's page, let every stage advance Australia fair. In joyful strains, then let us sing.
Good morning, everyone. Professor Marie Wilson, Chief Academic Services Officer, Senior Management and Staff of the University, graduates, ladies and gentlemen, good morning. As Deputy Chancellor of the University of South Australia, I'm delighted to welcome you to this graduation ceremony. At the outset, I acknowledge that the ceremony is taking place on Kaurna land. The Kaurna people have performed ceremonies on this land for many centuries, and we pay respect to their living culture and the unique role they continue to play in the life of the Adelaide region. Let me be the first to officially congratulate you on being here today and on getting your degrees, and for overcoming all the obstacles that life has thrust at you to receive it here on this day and in this place. You've worked long and hard to get to this point, and while I know that you cannot wait to start your celebrations, I'm here to tell you that your hard work has only just begun. Once today's celebrations are over, you will be faced with a future like few others have before you. It's a future with many unknowns, but I'm happy to say amongst those unknowns are some extraordinary possibilities. We are all facing challenges and uncertainties, no matter in what field our expertise lies. You will be asked to step up and contribute your talent, your education, and your commitment to whatever career you have chosen. The current health crisis has created many challenges to working life, but if anybody can navigate through these challenges, you can. If ever there was a cohort who could turn challenges into opportunities, it is you. You have proven to be adaptive, responsive and flexible. And if you've chosen a career that you're passionate about, truly amazing things will happen, because you'll find that the hard work isn't hard work at all. And as educated, competitive, spontaneous, adventurous and curious people, more than any other generation that came before, you are perfectly positioned for this time. The past year has taught us many lessons, but it has given us all a renewed sense of community and an opportunity to display the kindness, compassion, and sensitivity we are all capable of. You've been given the skills and knowledge to succeed in whatever career you've chosen to follow, and I wish you all the very best in your future endeavours. Many of you have already demonstrated how strong and resilient and open to possibilities you are, as you quickly and easily moved your studies and your work online in the face of the public health emergency. That's the sort of resilience that employers look for. Proof that you can and will adapt to changing circumstances. Proof that learning is so important to you that you continue to learn under any circumstances. Proof that your attitude and work ethic gives you the freedom to work independently. And proof that you'll let nothing stand in the way of achieving what you have set out to achieve. I would add to that, the soft skills that you bring to your new career environment will make all the difference. How we deal with challenges, how we support others to deal with challenges, makes us who we are. You have a duty to look out for your colleagues and treat them well, because that is what people will remember about you. Whatever degree you have studied, whatever career you are planning, and however keen you are to start the next phase of your life, please take a moment today to look back and congratulate yourselves on a job well done. All those long hours, late nights, and endless Zoom meetings were worth it. All of us here today, all the university people who have worked with you during your studies, share your pride and your joy. In building your knowledge and skills, it is our goal as a university to equip our graduates to make a real and enduring contribution to society. I wish you all the very best in your future endeavours. I'm certain one of the keys to your success has been the love, support, and encouragement of those closest to you, your family and your friends. I'm sure you're all aware, as am I, that without that support, you wouldn't be here today. So to demonstrate your appreciation, to thank your family and friends for their invaluable contribution, I ask you to stand, face your loved ones, and give them a big clap and a cheer. Thank you very much, graduates. It's now my pleasure to ask Chief Academic Services Officer, Professor Marie Wilson, to address you.
Good morning, and welcome to these special graduation ceremonies at UniSA. Congratulations on being a graduate. We know you've worked long and hard to finish your degrees, and that graduations are an important part of your passage into the next stage of your lives. And so we all sit here, sanitized, physically distanced, and ready to give you the appropriate send-off. During the past 12 months, we've all developed new ways of being. Besides the practical hygienic habits, we've all migrated safely to studying and working online, and seen our social interactions become two-dimensional on small screens while we fist-bumped and elbow-bumped our way through meetings in the corridor. But in the midst of all this change, one thing remains as true as it has always been: the importance of you actually being here, sharing your success and joy with the people, your family, friends, and teachers who helped you to get here on this day. This is the day that makes all the difference. It's the day of our success, yours in receiving the parchment you've worked so hard to get, and ours for steering you through the past few years, giving you the information you need, and then making sure that you learned it and used it effectively. This year marks our 30th anniversary of doing just that for the hundreds of thousands of students who have crossed the stage. And one aspect remains true of every graduation ceremony: you, graduates, taking fresh new credentials and enormous hope into a world alive with possibilities. For 30 years, they've been the nurses, teachers, scientists, engineers, therapists, artists, lawyers, and business people who power our economy and change our world. They are the people who you will join in the months and years ahead to do your part in pursuing your dreams and advancing society and your community. And yes, I know we have all taken a few hits in this past year, but we've learned valuable lessons. We've learned to value help and support that we give and receive, and to be agile, to be creative, to sidestep obstacles, and to build better solutions. The drama of the past 12 months or so has given us time to pause, to think, to reflect, and to contemplate the place in which we want to be, the place we want to take in this world. You have not only been given a solid base on which to build your future career, but you now have the added ability to turn obstacles into opportunity. Each of you has a history of challenges and travail. Remember, now and as you live your life, that there are many beautiful things that arise when things are a bit broken. I'm a quilter. I take old cloth, often torn but full of memories, and make quilts held together by sewing and embroidery that are beautiful and useful, if I do say so myself. Gardeners turn debris into compost and cuttings and seeds into beautiful gardens full of fruits, vegetables, and flowers. Broken tiles and plates become mosaics in many cultures, or in Japan may take on new life bound together with precious metal in an art form known as kintsugi, or golden repair. Repair is the essence of resilience. Our bumps and breaks, our setbacks, temper our resolve and lead us to savor success all the more. In Leonard Cohen's anthem, he wrote, "There is a crack in everything. That's how the light gets in." Through our unique experiences, we are able to leverage our resilience and what we have learned to craft a better future for ourselves, our families, and our world. It's how the light gets in. As you cross the stage today, hear your name and every clap and cheer as an affirmation of your achievements and of your future. Enjoy the light. I cannot think of a group of people more able to rise to the challenges ahead than the group that is gathered here today. As you leave here to take your place in the world, I know you'll make us proud. We already are. On behalf of UniSA, I wish each of you every success, every joy, and great fortune for the years to come. Thank you.
Thank you, Professor Wilson. I now invite Professor Roger Easton, Executive Dean, UniSA Allied Health and Human Performance, to begin the presentation of awards.
Deputy Chancellor, I present to you the candidates who have fulfilled the conditions for admission to awards of this university. I request that awards be confirmed in absentia upon the other candidates whose names appear in the graduation ceremony handbook.
Professor Easton, I have pleasure in conferring awards on all candidates who have complied with the prescribed requirements.
For the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, Jasveer Singh Bal, by thesis entitled Biomechanical Outcomes of Gait and Hip Joint Loading in Patients Undergoing Primary Total Hip Arthroplasty. Deputy Chancellor, I present Dr. Bal. For the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, Summer May Finley, by thesis entitled Understanding the Impacts of the National Key Performance Indicators on Aboriginal Community-Controlled Health Organisations. Deputy Chancellor, I present Dr. Finlay. For the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, Jordan Veselinov Kostadinov, by thesis entitled Validation of Process Evaluation Tools to Assess Community Readiness and Intervention Dose, Application to a Multi-Site Community-Based Childhood Obesity Prevention Program. Deputy Chancellor, I present Dr. Kostadinov. For the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, Amanda Jane Richardson, by thesis entitled Socio-Demographic and Time Use Predictors of First-Year University Student Success, ATAR and Beyond. Deputy Chancellor, I present Dr. Richardson. For the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, Bradley James Stenner, by thesis entitled Participation in Golf by Older Australians, Motivations for Playing and Evidence of Health-Related Benefits. Deputy Chancellor, I present Dr. Stenner. Deputy Chancellor, I present awards in UniSA Allied Health and Human Performance. For the degree of Master of Advanced Clinical Physiotherapy, Musculoskeletal, Pavel Henry Chuprin. Krupa Chandresh Kadakia. And Ellen Kate O'Callaghan. For the degree of Master of Advanced Clinical Physiotherapy Sports, Megan Jennifer Hallback. And Jane Sharon Rossiter. For the degree of Master of Physiotherapy graduate entry, Chloe Paige Boundy. And Sarah Xuan Tan Nguyen. For the Graduate Diploma in Medical Sonography, General, Alexandra Grace Brown. Chia Ying Ng. And Claire Victoria Tran. For the degree of Bachelor of Clinical Exercise Physiology Honours, Sophie Ellen Arkin. Teresa Grace Batista. Phoebe Kate Bowman. Shannon May Bubner. Ha Tailin Giang. Heidi Lauren Cloden. Peter Collis. Cara Grace Moore. James Liam Murray. Alicia Jade Payne. Shailen Matilda Rector. Kathy Ann Rowe. And Nia Hai Tran. For the degree of Bachelor of Physiotherapy honours, Marianne Marcia Frost. Georgia Elder Goss. Lucy Jane Mayo. Amy Marie Skipworth. Anne Marie Stankevicius. And Claire Georgia Turnbull. For the degree of Bachelor of Health Science and recipient of the University of South Australia Medal, Daniel Akers. For the degree of Bachelor of Health Sciences, Anurit Deep Kaur. Gahagi. Hannah Rose Best. Christian Carbone. Shannon Laura Packer. Nam Quoc Tran. And Shireen Teresa D'Souza. For the degree of Bachelor of Health Studies, Sherlin Chiang Zilin. For the degree of Bachelor of Human Movement, Daniel Graham Chappelle Baggs. Savannah Jane Barnden. Hannah Joy Bush. Emma Louise Hoskins. Cassidy Camille Hearn. Zi Juan Ng. Bethany Rosa Grace Rother. Lauren Kate Sibley. Brandon Gareth Swain. And Jack Harry Tingey. For the degree of Bachelor of Podiatry, Isabel Limbert Jilks. Hajir Idris. Chi Quinn T. Nguyen. And Rachel Glenda Vale. Deputy Chancellor, I present awards in UniSA Clinical and Health Sciences for the degree of Master of Health Services Management, ANMOL. Ma Alexandra Celine Malilin Bartolone. Thrivikram Amadi. Parul Kathwas. Rajdeep Kaur. Supreet Kaur. Akanksha Luthra. Benedict Ebubetuku Okonjo. Riti Pundia. Shagan Puri. Kinjal Atik Kumar Shah. Ayushi Sharma. Gloria Chepchumba Two. And Srinidhi Vedala. For the degree of Bachelor of Laboratory Medicine Honours, John Mark Denton. Cassie Ha. N.U. Wesley Ho. Felicia U. Danning. Sarah Marie Jess. Alexandra Sylvia Kay. Danny Chiang. Donna Ann Scopacaza. Meghana Sunkanpally. Serena Yong Hui Tan. Kai Yuan T. and Emily Marie Zott. For the degree of Bachelor of Midwifery, Kaniel Kubilias. Brooke Sheridan Freeman. Christine Jayan Bioti Star Gagloon. Brooke Taylor Michelani. Mansoori Savori. Shanice Tegan Seboff. Brianna Rose Silvestri. Kayla Lee Stevens. Erin Talbot. Karen Louise Tiller. Lauren Kate Walker. And Cassandra Joy Wolf. Deputy Chancellor, this concludes the presentation of awards.
Thank you, Professor Easton. Graduates, you have shared one of the most significant periods of your life with your colleagues at the University of South Australia. You have worked hard and earned a degree from one of the world's best young universities. Besides giving you the best academic start to your future careers, we want you to be productive members of society And that is why we put so much emphasis on readying you for your future careers. Because of that, we have the best record among the state's universities for our graduate employment numbers. I know that in whatever your field of expertise, you will make a valuable and lasting contribution to your own communities and take your part in a rapidly growing network of UniSA-inspired success stories, people who are all doing interesting and good work right across the world. And while on the subject of UniSA success stories, today we're assembled in the cultural and sporting heart of UniSA, Pridham Hall, where we celebrate all of our successes, including yours today. This building was made possible by a South Australian success story, a man named Andrew Pridham. Andrew is an alumnus of ours who, like you, graduated and went on to make his mark upon the world before he came back to contribute to UniSA's vision for the future. So strong was his connection to the university that he felt enabled his success, first in property management and then in merchant banking. Andrew came back and donated $5 million towards this building, the largest single philanthropic donation this university has received to date. Andrew Pridham graduated from us with all the attributes that you graduate with today. You have the qualifications, coupled with the passion to do something positive. You can make real change in the world. And I hope you stay in touch with us and let us know what you are up to. You can do this through our alumni network, which now has almost 250,000 members. It is a network that is there to help you, to support you, and to give you that connection back to your university. As you leave us today, I wish you a world of opportunity and good fortune. But before you go, stay seated while the rest of us in this assembly stand to congratulate you and wish you well on your journey.